And for those of you who don't know, BJ is my boyfriend's a brother. And so for us to be sitting down and be getting nasty, oh Lord. Depending on who you're talking to, it's I don't know. A little weird, but this ain't that. So let's get into it. So you are a former football player.
Yes, I
Can
am,
you
sir.
name drop some of the teams that you played for? How long? Take us back.
I was a graduate from the University of Connecticut in 2015. I graduated with a degree in sociology, with a minor in criminology and also criminal studies. I was hoping to get into law, sort of like family law. I wanted to get into family court, but my coaches had other plans for me. So after the 2015 Pro Day, which is kind of like your college's combine that you have, I signed a deal with the Philadelphia Eagles, and my contract there was, it was supposed to be for 3 years, but due to some injury and basically it was the injury that halted me from being on the Eagles long term. I was actually a basketball player, and if my dad could have written my story, I'd have been a boxer and a basketball player, or a boxer or a basketball player. My dad was a basketball player in Pittsburgh, and that was actually my dream. I wanted to play hoops in college. I had some lower, I won't say lower tier, but like not as popular college offers for basketball that I was actually willing to take. But after a year of football, I mean, the offers just started to they started to flood in, and I really think that's like where God was showing me, like, hey man, you can do what you want, but hey, you got some more options if you decide to play outside instead of inside, if you catch my drift.
Is
So
when that door gets open, but then an injury happens.
yes.
Like that's like a major, like what in the world? So
That
like,
was rough.
can you walk us through that process?
I got the injury. I don't I kind of wear my emotions on my sleeve, and anybody that's played any sports with me, they know, like, we know when BJ's happy, we know when he's sad, we know the different emotions. So the team doctor tells me, like, you're not gonna have a rookie season. You were doing great, but yeah, you're pretty much like, you're damaged goods right now. So I say, doc, be honest with me. What does it look like that I'll be able to play again? He's like, I believe you'll be able to play again. He said, just not this year. So after that, if I had to put a definition to strength, I had to put my own definition to strength, I would say that it would be your ability to rise in situations that are blatantly putting you down, blatantly meant to, and if not put you down, pressure you, very heavily pressure you. Your ability to rise in situations of great pressure, because I would say that a lot of times that is where my strength has resided, on the field and off the field. But real strength comes from, right up here, whenever you decide to hit that switch and go, well, okay, I heard what you said, I heard what you said, but I'm going to, if I'm going to win, I may even have to lose a little bit, So I think the strength is when you go the course, or you rise, you stay the course when you have a great deal of pressure against you. Earlier,
Indeed.
being a father, a brother, losing my sister when I was in college, that was a brutal, a very brutal thing, especially since I wasn't there when it happened. Mental health was a major factor in my decision to keep playing football even then. I had coaches, players, people saying different things to me on every side, things that would probably make y'all's jaw drop. Like but strength, that mental strength.
It's sure important.
But I think the most important thing about that idea with men and men's health and mental health is one, to be heard. You know, I hear a lot of social media talk. I'll even sit down, and it's real easy to get lost on TikTok. You hear an Andrew Tate conversation, you hear this one, you hear that one, and then you have Kanye having us all looking, you know, like, what's going on? I think that the most important thing is to be heard. And after you're heard, you know, you isolate what the issues are that you're dealing with, and then you just work on them.